Sleep studies can tell doctors a lot about our health, but sometimes having one done can be a little bit nerve-wracking. So today I'm with Dr. Medaglia to really take a closer look at what a sleep study entails. But I think the first thing that everyone needs to know, doctor, is that sleep studies can tell doctors a lot.
Absolutely. Sleep studies are extremely important and give us information about whether there is or is not the presence of a sleep disorder. Some of the common sleep disorders that we're looking for, mainly sleep apnea. We're also looking for periodic limb movement disorder and narcolepsy.
All right, let's talk about what the doctors are measuring and monitoring.
All the wires are pasted just on the top of your head. Those wires on the top of your head give us information about brainwave patterns to tell us what stages of sleep the patient is in.
So when people are coming in for the sleep study and they have to get all wired up and sleep overnight, it can be a little nerve-wracking and scary. What do you tell them to say, hey, this is okay?
The biggest thing that they should know is that nothing hurts at all. And actually, the information that we're getting is so important and it's so imperative and can improve so much in terms of your health and daytime functioning that it's just kind of important to just go through the motions, get the sleep study done, and let the rest take its course.
With that, I went to check out the sleep study room in person.
Okay, doctor, I am in my PJs, ready for bed, so let's get started.
Okay. So we are gonna first get started with having you put this belt on. This belt is actually used to measure your effort to breathe. We would go ahead and then use leads around your eyes. We're using this to measure your eye movements.
This is monitoring my muscle tension in my jaw.
Yeah, so this is measuring muscle tone in your jaw. See if there is evidence of bruxism or teeth grinding. If you want to have a seat, then we're going to go ahead and put some other leads on. And then it goes right here.
And what is this monitoring?
This is just measuring your heart rate patterns. Sleep apnea can be associated with abnormalities, PVCs, sinus pauses. Not always, but can be.
Okay.
So you just want to make sure that we pick those up if they are indeed present. These leads here actually go on your legs to see if there are any limb movements.
Next was some equipment that went over my ears and onto my nose.
We are using this to measure your respiratory pattern.
Finally, Dr. Medaglia taped one more wire to my finger to measure if I have any oxygen drops during my sleep study.
And then we're able to look at your brain waves, your breathing patterns, and your leg movements, all from the computer screen.
It's pretty straightforward, a lot of wires, but I know what I'm in for. So,
right.
Sleep study, what's the bottom line?
Bottom line is nothing hurts. It's not as scary as people think. Having this sleep study done gives us extremely important data to be able to answer the question of whether or not you have a sleep disorder. That information is invaluable to help us best take care of you and improve your overall health.
Great information. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
All right, this will be lights out on my sleep study, but for more information on how other medical procedures work, just head to our website, livinghealthytv.com.